The strong sense of family that Janet was reared with has extended to include her stable of dancers, whom she affectionately refers to as the kids. The troupe is so tight that Janet flew the entire lot to Hawaii for tour rehearsals.
I just think it's very important to have friends. And not just to have friends, but to have, you know, friendship is, it's a genuine friendship is very hard to find. It truly is. And I don't have a lot of friends, but the ones that I do have, I've known for years. I think it's really important when you find those special people, key people in your life, to hold on and to be there for them as they would for you, really. It's really important.
It's just such a wonderful job. I mean, everybody gets along with so much love and support, and Janet is, like, wonderful. I mean, sometimes I just forget that she's, you know, I just, because she's so wonderful. It's like Janet is just she's one of the homegirls. Like, what's up?
She never makes anybody feel like less than what she is. And
totally.
And like, I think that's good, and it kind of rubs off on us, you know. We don't ever take that for granted.
What you see is exactly what you get. She's as real as they come.
It's hard work, but you know, I love it. It's fun for me. It never really stops. I work out 6 days a week, about an hour and a half, 2 hours before I go to rehearsal. So after rehearsal, no, before rehearsal I work out, then right after working out, I go to rehearsal. I still have to watch what I eat, because I mean, you can easily put on fat and not the muscle mass that you want, really. So you have to, no sweets or anything like that, I do like strawberries and whipped cream and Haagen-Dazs strawberry ice cream, but, and caramel apples, but I really, and sweet potato pie. Let me stop.
With her new streamlined physique, Janet called upon the talents of Rhythm Nation director Dominic Senna to direct her next video, If.
It's all about sort of hypothetical situations. If I was your lover, the things I'd do to you. And so the idea just came to me to sort of pursue the element of voyeurism.
Very sensual. Very sexy, which is what I wanted to do. It's different, I mean, from Rhythm Nation, very, you know. So, I love it though, it's fun. It's very strong and yet very feminine, and you get to feel all over the guys, you know, it's fun, you know?
I didn't have any problem with Janet pushing me around at all, you know? She's easy to work with. She's easy to vibe off of and whatnot, you know? She slapped my bald head a couple times too hard, but, you know, that was no problem.
I think he liked it more than I did. I really do.
Early on, when we started talking about this Chinese motif, well, I had started looking at books and things, and actually there was a Japanese troupe, Buto troupe, theatrical sort of dance troupe. And I love the image of these sort of men being lowered by ropes and things. And so I brought the idea to Janet and Renee, and they loved it and thought, this is terrific. You know, this would be a great way to intro the men.
It's scary. He said it was strenuous.
It's stressful. It's really strenuous. It's hard.
I think it's fun, myself. I think it's fun.
There were a few screams and shouts in between takes, and help me, and I'm not going to make it, and somebody catch somebody, or a mattress wouldn't, like, get put into position, and somebody would be coming down about, you know, 6 feet a second, and somebody push a mattress underneath them. So it was a little hairier than I thought it would be.
Dance and choreography in videos is very important to me, because my music is dance music, really. And I really can't imagine myself standing there, all these cuts or this or that, and just me up against a wall or lying down or something. I think that's what the kids like to see as well, knowing that my music is dance music and that I dance. They like to see that. And I enjoy doing it, really.
Janet can come in and, you know, be gone for a week and go over the combination, go over whatever routine we're working on. And at the end, you know, I always give everyone their corrections. And she'll do it the next time and do it completely right. She soaks up all the, you know, all the corrections, like, no problem, just like a computer.
There's that, you know, the part where we're behind Jan and it's all just, you know, a lot of hand movements and, you know, sexy face and all right. that. And then there's like the actual,
the hard,
you know.
Hitting all the accents, all that.
Yeah, and just, that is stuff you just have to go crazy on and just give it all you got.
I don't think videos are played out, or I think it's the same people that say, oh, rap is no good and that's dead, that's tart, and it's definitely, I love rap music.
When it came time for Janet to cut her rap track entitled New Agenda, she called upon rapper Chuck D of Public Enemy to collaborate.
He's a great rapper. He's very strong, and he's very well respected by the kids and the rap community. He's incredible at what he does.
I try to tell people to educate them on, you know, exactly, you know, don't, you know, before you talk, you know, before you put your mouth in gear, you know, put your brain on start.
I've learned a lot from rap as well. I mean, I feel in school we weren't taught, really. Only that we were slaves, really, and not kings and queens. And I feel that rap has educated myself as well, there, as well as other races, about our history, our past. And I think it's a great thing. I really do.
Our time has come to rejoice.
By making her debut in director John Singleton's film Poetic Justice, Janet has turned more than a few of Hollywood's heads. The film took the number one position at the box office for its opening weekend.
I feel that John's really great at that. He knows what people, it seems like, what really connect and what really makes a great story, you know what I mean? Which is really the most important thing.
Acting again for the first time since her childhood seems to have had a great impact on Janet.
It was really Poetic Justice, the film, that opened me up a great deal and made me want to express my feelings, Maya Angelou's poetry, and just the whole story, the whole Poetic Justice story.
A wise man once said, you should look at the ocean and realize that no matter how famous you are or how much money you make, you should know that you'll never be as important as the ocean.
She's gone through a lot of pain, a lot of tragedy in her life, and she expresses herself through her poetry. That's how she kind of, that's her escapism. That's how she kind of frees herself from all the pain. What really moved me is music. So I remember for that scene, I sat in my trailer and I listened to a lot of different songs that really made me feel that way, or that reminded me of that time in my life. I basically draw on my past. And I know a lot of people say, oh God, no. You lived in Encino, you haven't felt any pain, this and that. But I really have gone through a great deal from the age 16 to about 19 and a half. I went through a lot that I really don't wish upon anyone, really. And I drew upon those times.
What did you write about?
It was in my heart.
What's that?
Do I feel that I'm a natural actress? I want to say yes. I'm a natural actress. Oh God. What's your name?
Lucky.
Lucky.
Yeah.
Come here, Lucky. I want to whisper something to you. first cut the cord, okay? Now, what do you really, really want from me?
Everyone has this perception either of me being this little stuck-up thing or very shy when they see interviews and things like that. Or, well, I should say this. I think people will be surprised.
You want to smell my...
Yeah.
You like that, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Hold on a minute, baby.
It's been one of my goals for a very long time to do a film, to see my face on the big screen. And I want to have a career at acting the way I do in music. And it's really important to me that it does well, the film, that the kids really enjoy it.
Once Poetic Justice was completed, Janet started shooting the video for Again, the song she wrote specifically for the film. Once again, she decided to team up with director and longtime friend, Rene Elizondo.
I thought, what a great way to do a video, what a great approach to video would be is to see her in her creative mode writing the song for Poetic Justice that she actually did.
Normally I write in the bed when I'm writing, like for the album. I'd stay in a lot and just write in my bedroom, in the bed with my pajamas on.
I heard from a friend today, and she said you were in town. Suddenly the memories came to me in my mind.
Originally, I was going to be in my pajamas coming up with the melody and the lyrics and rewinding the footage from the film and it basically being about the film, really. So that's how it started out. And then it went from there. And then, well, it might be kind of cool to have a guy in this. And then you thinking about your past, something that's happened in your past, and how you're writing this song about the film, but also it pertains to something that's really happened in your life.
One thing I've always felt about her is she can be natural and a technician at the same time. I mean, you can honestly say to her, do that line 1 second less, and she'll give it to you exactly without losing any of the feeling.
What does the future hold for myself? Definitely more films. Definitely. And more music. And I think that's about all I should say right now.